I've been profoundly deaf ever since I was born, but I wasn't diagnosed until I was 1 year old. My foster family suspected I was deaf, but every time they taught me to get tested, I would always respond to the sounds made by a drum or a triangle. Little did they know, I was just watching a professional in the reflection of the window I was facing, so I was responding to them by sight. I was a clever baby, wasn't I? Eventually, they confirmed I was deaf. When I came to live with my adopted mum at 16 months, I had hearing aids, but I refused to wear them because they didn't help. I could not hear anything with the hearing aids, and it just did not work for me. Mum then looked at different options, and she found one that was promising. And assessments, I was given the thumbs up to have a cochlear implant. A cochlear implant is a device that works by turning sound into electrical signals and sending them to part of the inner ear called the cochlea. From here, the signals travel to the brain and is heard as sound. Getting a cochlear implant wasn't an easy task back then because it needed to have a big operation on your ear. I have a scar from where they cut the back of the ear up in order to put the implant. They had to use a drill into the skull to feed the wires into the cochlea and then place the magnet just under the skin. The implant has two main parts, a microphone behind the ear that picks up sound and changes into electrical signals, which are sent along a wire to the coil on the skin, and a device that is placed inside the skull that picks up the electrical signals from the coil on the skin and sends them along the wires to the cochlea, which is then translated into sound. If I switch on my implant a few weeks after the operation, I began to hear sound for the first time, but I wasn't able to understand the voices. See, you need to train your brain because it has never heard sound before. This was helped by speech and language therapy, where I learned to speak and hear audio slowly. When I started speaking more coherently, I was about 9 years old. Asking, how did I communicate before I spoke? I use sign language and I still use it now. Sign language is a visual means of communicating using gestures, facial expressions, and body language. It is preferred by most deaf and hard of hearing people. I always find it difficult to understand people when they are speaking to me, and I have to often tell them to slow down and speak clearly. I can't hear the voices very well, and I have to use lip reading. On the visual, not the auditory. The word lip reading implies reading, like reading a book whose book is legible and clear. But the human face isn't a book, and lip reading is not reading. People mumble. People talk fast and laugh loud. People have facial hair like porcupines and like sphincters. People cover their mouths. People have accents. Way to cope, seeing at the speed of sound. Many different skills, and I kept having to need because none of the skills were prepared for someone who was deaf. They didn't know how to educate me. They didn't know how to help me. As a result, I fell back behind my peers, and my learning was severely delayed until I went to a boarding school specialized for deaf students. I caught up and I was overachieving in many subjects, but I was being bullied for being different. I had to leave school and I was homeschooled for 2 years until I attended Riverside. The staff at Riverside always went above and beyond for me, helping me to work through my issues and helped me to assess the conversation and subjects. It's hard, especially if you're deaf. I've applied for McDonald's and got the job, but I was let go after a shift. I wasn't suitable to work because I couldn't hear people talking to me, and it was dangerous for me to be in the kitchen because of health and safety regulations. This was discrimination, but unfortunately this wasn't my first experience with a blatant discrimination, so I just accepted it and moved on. Life is too short to hold grudges. Finding a job can be hard, but I was lucky. I could be a cell coffee evening. I was talking about the difficulties of finding a job, as I had been looking for weeks prior. There was a man attending. His name was Mark. He kindly offered me a job. Mark is the artistic director of Prime Theatre, which is a theatre company that has a new theatre for children. They produce professional shows, and they do workshops in schools too. My job was to become a deaf signer for 3 non-deaf children that attended a new theatre. I became a role model for the children, and they were able to access more out of the workshops. I made connections in the theatre industry, which will prove to be valuable. In a Prime Theatre, I fell in love with drama, and I decided to attend the workshops myself. Prime Theatre New Theatre produced a show called This Is Our Town, which explored the history of what Swindon was like in the 1900s. I was cast as the milkman Howard Webb. Prime adapted the role of Howard Webb to be a deaf milkman to fit me, and assigned and spoke my lines, and I learned about physical theatre. We polished up the production, and then we performed at the Steam Museum for 3 consecutive nights. This production was my taste of performing, and I fell in love with it. Studied acting at New College Swindon for 1 year, and I have loved the experience. I studied texts from playwrights. I learned about famous playwrights. Performed unit tests and experimented with the Brechtian technique. I had decided to study performing arts for 4 3 years this September. A skilled worker at Prime Theatre assisting workshops, and have now become a non-trustee on the board. My confidence has come up in leaps and bounds, and I can't wait to see what the future brings. You are someone struggling with your identity. Please don't be afraid to explore it. Be confident, try things, and you never know, you may like it. If I can do it, you can do it too. Be yourself, dare to be yourself.